Okay, in this problem, let's take a look at how we record something called unearned revenue and how it impacts the basic accounting equation. So in this transaction, the company received a $600 cash advance for a six-month revenue contract beginning on November 1st. So what happened here is the customer came to you, the company, and asked you to do some work for them over the next 6 months. And they decided to pay you the entire contract in advance, which is always nice. So you got the $600 cash right up front. Let's start with this transaction by recording the impact of cash as an increase. Okay, but we do know that the revenue recognition principle requires that we actually only record revenue when it's earned. And at this point in time on November 1st, we haven't earned anything at this point. The revenue is going to be earned as we actually perform the services over the next 6 months. So we can't really record an increase to revenue even though we recorded an increase to cash here. So we'll need to do something though to balance out this equation. The counterbalance to this equation goes to something called unearned revenue, which is exactly what it is. So we're going to put an increase here under this liability. Now the reason why it's a liability is because you basically owe those services to the customers at this point. Another way to think about it is if this customer came in, say, later on that same day before you've done any work and canceled the contract, you'd likely have to give them the $600 back at that point because we haven't done any work. Our basic accounting equation is imbalanced because we increased assets and we increased liabilities at the same time. In terms of a cash flow, this would be a plus operating. Okay, let's flash forward now to December 31st, 2 months later. The problem says to adjust the records to record the revenue earned on the November 1st contract. So in order to do this entry, we'll need to do a little bit of a calculation here. We could probably do this in our head, but just so we can work this out, the first thing that we'll want to do is put this cash advance into a monthly amount. So if we received $600 up front, and it was for a six-month contract, we just divide the 600 by 6, and we're talking about basically $100 a month on this contract to be earned. Next, you just need to ask how many months have passed. Well, in this case, the contract was on November 1st, so all of November and all of December have passed, so we've earned 2 months of work on this contract. So we're just going to take this $100, multiply it by 2, and say that we've got a full $200 earned on this contract. Now, of course, this assumes that we're earning amounts evenly in this contract. It may not be that case. If that were the case, they may have told us exactly how much was earned on this contract. But if the problem is presented to you in this fashion, you'd actually have to do this calculation based on the number of months to get just how much is earned. So in this case, what we're going to do, now remember, we're not going to have any additional impact to cash because we did that already way back on November 1st. What we're going to do here is we're just going to, first of all, make an adjustment to the unearned revenue account, the liability account, to show a decrease in this account for the amount that's now been earned on this contract. So we're going to decrease this account by $200. That's the amount that's been earned. Next, we're going to record an increase to revenues for that same amount. Now, of course, we know when revenue increases, the impact to net income is also an increase. And when net income increases, we know that our retained earnings also increases. And the cash flow, in this case, would be NA or no, because there was no cash involved in this adjustment. What this does, this adjustment does, is brings our liability in line with where it should be at the end of the year. And to answer this question at the bottom here is how much is left to be earned on the revenue contract at December 31st? Well, if you put this into months, you can see here there's basically 4 months still left to be earned at $100 a month, or a total of $400, or the account balance in the unearned revenue account.